Hello and welcome. Today we unbox the ASUS Prime X570P motherboard. I got this motherboard for my new computer. It's the ASUS Prime X570P. It's an AM4. It supports the latest Ryzen 3000 series out of the box. And it has the latest chipset, the X570 chipset. And some HDMI ports and PCI Express 4.0, that's pretty nice. Looking at the box, there are a lot of features for this motherboard. Even though this is almost, I think, is the cheapest motherboard you can get with the X570 chipset, it still has a lot of features. The HDMI port works only if you have a processor, a CPU that supports, that has a graphical interface built in, a GPU built in. Lots of USB ports, 3.2 Gen 1 and Gen 2, and also USB 2.0. Lots of USB ports for this motherboard. It has a gigabit Ethernet connection and audio that is separated from the main board. You will see later what I mean. It has RGB features if you're interested in that. Addressable header Gen 2. I don't know much about RGB. These are the processors that are accepted. The chipset X570, the latest one. It can have DDR4 memory with really good speeds. I will use a DDR4 3200 memory on this one. And this, for storage, it has 6 SATA ports and 2 M.2 slots, which is pretty good. And if you want to have the to use the built-in HDMI port, you need a processor that one of the Ryzen processors that has I believe the C code. I'm not sure. Write in the comments, or I will write later which processors support this built-in video feature. Lots of PCI Express slots, and the PCI Express version is 4.0. For a GPU that supports 4.0 or an M.2 SSD, which has a really fast speed if it's on PCI Express 4.0. Let's unbox this. This knife really needs to be sharpened. Okay, let's move on. So let's see what's inside the box. Firstly, most important, you have to be careful when you handle the motherboard because it's an electrostatic discharge sensitive device. So wear one of those electrostatic bracelets, or if you don't have one of those, touch some metal part in your house that is grounded. And best case is just touch the computer case and then handle the motherboard. If you can avoid touching the electronic parts, don't touch them. So, and also keep it in this bag. This is a anti-electrostatic discharge, anti-ESD bag. Try to keep it in this bag for as long as you can. Let's see what other things are inside the magic box. Some cables. It's a bit hard to remove them, but okay, we could take them out. Cables and some other stuff below. Let's first look at the cables. Two SATA cables. One is straight and the other one is 90 degree angle. That's pretty nice. I thought they should give more SATA cables, but okay. This is some RGB connection. I don't know what that is. Under this paper thing, we have the firewall for the motherboard. This goes into your case. Try not to lose that. These are M.2 screws so that you can install your SSD, super fast M.2 SSDs, and some paperwork. The most important paper here for you, if you're going to install this, is the quick installation guide, where it will tell you step by step how to install it. I followed this one and it worked perfectly. You will see later. You will see in another video. If you want to pause at each step, I'm not going to explain now all the steps, but if you follow this guide, it's very easy just build the computer as long as you have all the parts that you need with you and they are compatible, of course. So that's how you install the memory and different versions for the coolers. These are the Ryzen coolers. It's pretty straightforward. They even show you how to install the graphics card and the motherboard, the connectors for the power button and LED, and the ATX connector. Basically everything that you need to know, it's here. I think you can find this online, I'm not sure, but when you get the motherboard, this will be in the box. Do not throw this away, and before you install it, make sure you read this paper, because it's really important that you do everything right. These are the connections, it shows you how to install it. Pretty straightforward. Thanks for this. Let's move on to the next thing. Of course, I couldn't pack it as it was before, that's normal. And the DVD with some drivers which are probably outdated anyway. So I don't think you would want to use this DVD. You should download the drivers from the internet. But if you don't have an internet connection, this is pretty good start. Here, this one gift for you. If you want to use this coupon, please go ahead. It's one, so whoever sees this video first and needs it, just try to use it. If it doesn't work, someone else used it. I'm not gonna use it, so it's yours. The manual is pretty well structured. You have all the usual information you would want to see about the components in the package, and the most important, the motherboard layout, so you know where is each port and what everything, every connection does. That's the description. How to install the memory, again it's important the order which you install it. And the manual you can find online for sure, so if you want to read that manual before you get the motherboard, it's easy to look it up and download it from the ASUS website. That's the shield for the motherboard. This goes into the case. You make sure you don't lose that. And this is pretty much it. That's everything. So let's have a look at the actual motherboard. Let's take it out from the package. Now handling it, try not to touch something. I didn't use a strap here, a ESD bracelet. But I wasn't touching any sensitive parts, just touching the coolers or plastic components. That's how it looks like. There is a cooler on the chipset. Board looks decent, it doesn't look like a spaceship, but it doesn't matter, it's in the case. Full-size PCI Express slot for the GPU, 16X, and then the smaller PCI Express slots, and another full-size PCI Express slot, which is useful for other cards. Processor PGA slot, and the power is really kept cool with nice radiators of aluminium. And here you have the chipset, which is also kept cool with a fan. There you have USB connections, fast USB connections, SATA, 6 SATA connections. Some M.2 slot, which is a longer size, and a shorter size M.2. A bunch of connections for USB, and these are headers for the front panel. And the audio, which is separated, you see this channel is separating it from the main board to isolate it, so it's less noisy. These are pretty good from aluminium. Those are power for the processors and the fan, controllers, sockets and whatever. Memory, 4 slots of memory, that's pretty nice. I mean, for a board that is supposed to be low cost entry level board, this has a lot of features. USB 2.0, the USB 3.2. HDMI, which will not work with my processor, and Ethernet, gigabit Ethernet, and the sound card could have had more inputs and outputs. Here, these ones, they act as jack sensing, so if you plug in a microphone, it will work as a microphone. If you plug in a speaker, it will output signal. So still, it could have had more audio outputs, but usually if you want more quality from audio, you get something extra. This is the board, and I will install this in a future video, and subscribe to see that. Let me know how you think about this board, if you think the Pro is better, because there is an X570 Pro. If you think that one is better, also the price is much more expensive. So if you chose that, write in the comments why you chose that, or if you chose this board, write in the comments why you prefer this one. Subscribe, like and share, and I will see you next time. Bye.